Hello everyone, I am Aditya from Section D and I'll be talking about inequality. So inequality is the quality of being unequal or uneven, such as social disparity, disparity among distribution and opportunity, or lack of evenness. So inequality has been a key theme in the research agenda of economists for a long time. And I find out two reasons why this could be the case. The intrinsic ethical attractiveness of equality, that equality is such a known thing and then people want to be equal. The significant implications of inequality for various macroeconomic variables like growth and poverty. Although issues related to inequality can be analyzed along several dimensions, we deal mostly with inequality in income or consumption and wealth. Before undertaking a study of inequality, one is always confronted with an issue on how to measure inequality. So we know that it is almost impossible to describe and compare and try to find out the distribution of income of the whole population. So it is necessary to have some measures that we can use to find this inequality. So Gini coefficient is one of those measures which measures the extent to which distribution of income or consumption among individuals deviates from the equal distribution. A high value of this coefficient signifies an more unequal distribution. In the Indian context, the consumption expenditure surveys constitute the most basic source of inequality measurement. These surveys are conducted on a regular basis over a fairly large sample of households. Data has been collected to analyze the income shares of individuals in the top earning brackets. Since most of the population is exempted from taxation, it is possible only to look at the top 1% of the population. So historically, if we see, during 1950s, the inequality levels were very high. The average Gini index was around 35. Through 1950s and 1960s, there was a steady decline in these measures. The index fell from 35 to 30. The income share of the top 1% also showed a significant decline. Many scholars attribute this trend to the slower growth and the socialist policies that were introduced during this period. Then inequality measures remained fairly stable during the 1970s and 80s, and there is no evidence of any clearly increasing or decreasing trend. So this trend is more pronounced if the rural and the urban populations are segregated, since the urban inequality is greater than the inequality among the rural households. Greater urbanization during this period could have been the reason for that. This is also observed in the early 1990s. So also we can see that the share of the top 1% of the population did turn around in 1980s after falling for almost 3 decades. We can see that at around 2004, the inequality had increased to 36.8. So this is clear that the top bottom 20% of the population lost their consumption share, and the rich 20% had a good share of consumption. The higher, so we see that from this, we can see that inequality has been risen on several fronts. So broad trends of differentiation in the income distribution of India can be seen in the regional distribution, where we can see the inequality which arises in between the states. So we can see that interstate inequality was steady in 1970s and 80s. Then it rose, and then we can see that the best and the worst performers earlier were Punjab and Haryana being the best performers, and Odisha and Bihar being in the bottom of the table. So we can see there are evidences of wage inequality too. So summarizing this, we can see that even though not alarmingly high, there is some evidence of rising inequality in India in the last few decades. Though it is very early and premature to say that this rise is due to the process of India being liberalized and liberalization of itself. However, inequality needs to be kept with a close watch, and the rising trend needs to be studied properly, because in the end, India is a developing country, and this is one major quality that India should develop, and low inequalities will be a great measure of the growth of India.